and she doesn't look happy. Yeah. None of them look happy.
Three daughters. I thought you just had to have big, beautiful weddings anyway.
Well, I just think your daughter likes getting married.
Maybe you shouldn't give her such a big one next time.
Daisy Mae, there's not going to be a next time now, I'm telling you that. I'll tell you, this one is for keeps.
Well, so is mine. I'm only getting married once.
Oh, of course you are, honey. My daughter said the same thing. Each time.
Well, Dee and I, we've talked about it, and neither of us believe in a horse. I mean, horse isn't even an option. So we're going to have a Christian marriage. God is going to be the center of our relationship. We've been going to marriage counseling, reading our Bible each morning, praying together, and we're really learning what it means to love one another.
Y'all are going to marriage counseling already?
Well, better before than after.
Here's your tea, girls. Morning, Daisy Mae and Charlotte.
Thank you so much.
Morning. Care for any tea?
Tea? Are you kidding me? Well, Madge, you have me coffee, and I like it black, I like it rich and dark, how I like my men, you know?
Yes, I will. You can see that I picked up already, so you have to wait for a while.
Oh, well, that's no problem. We'll keep ourselves busy. We should have called first, but I made an appointment that just walking in. We had no idea you'd be this busy. I will just look here at my hair and see if I can come up with something that you can do my hair with.
Now, Charlotte, you said that you were hoping Melissa would be here this morning.
Daisy Mae, why don't you check on that coffee and see if it's ready?
Okay?
Christian girl.
me. And you know he said yes. Well then, so I asked him if, well, he would die for me. And he said no.
He said no.
He said no. He said his love was an undying love.
Well, you ladies can joke all you want, but I'm taking this marriage thing very seriously.
Well, my, Loretta, what a strong, serious type of girl you've raised here. There must have been some good teaching by you. I mean, she sounds like you 30 years ago.
No, sure you could, Loretta.
Come on.
Don't be shy.
Well, yes, Loretta, dear. I want to hear this. I might learn something.
Well, okay. Every week we go out to eat.
That's it?
Well, let me finish. We go to a nice restaurant twice a week.
Have a nice candlelit dinner.
Soft music, and then a slow
walk home.
He goes on Mondays, and I go on Thursdays. Started. wouldn't tell me where we were going on our honeymoon. So I asked, well, where are we staying tonight? Well, since he's not a planner, he didn't get a hotel. So we drove and drove. From 7 o'clock on, we kept stopping at every motel to see if there was a room, and there were no rooms. Finally, at 2 o'clock in the morning, we pulled into a motel, and the manager told Greg that there were no rooms available because all the bikers had disturbed us, and there were alcohol terminals, but that we could sleep in the parking lot in the car, and that it was safe, it was controlled. So we talked about it, and we decided we'd do that. And as we were talking, I told Greg about what had happened and where I had to go to use the restroom before the wedding. And that's when he confessed to me that he was there. He, of course, had forgot to put gas in the car, so just before the wedding, he made a mad dash to the station to fill the car up. And he saw a long line of women waiting to use the restroom at the station, and he saw me come out in my gown and talk to Cheryl. So we had a nice laugh about that, which kind of took the edge off of having to spend the night in the car.
So he ended up seeing you anyway after all that?
After all that.
Oh, what a funny story.
Hey, Michelle, will you tell us about your wedding day?
Well, what happened on all that?
Well,
special, y'all. I just love this. Charlotte, this was a good idea coming here this morning.